My job is in the state office making statistics the whole day, boring statistics. But sometimes I have to entertain farmers. I want them to make statistics for me. It's just for the information I give them back. It's a difficult job, so I hope I can make a good show for you now, and I don't want to bore you. So I want to give you statistic information. So, where and how consumers pushing suppliers? Let's have a look in the mirror, or in the magic crystal cube. Can we learn something about from the past? Here, 200 miles away, Johann Heinrich von Thünen had a farm, a big farm, and he noticed where the crops were planted. So you have to plant vegetables and milk, produce milk next to consumers. And he found the solution. It's because of the transport charges. So you have to produce milk next to the consumers, because imagine that time, it's August, it's hot, so milk gets sour. Drunken carriage driver, and that's today, perfect service from your dairy company. So the transport charges are not so important than in former times. Therefore, we have this pattern of production in Europe. Agribusiness is a European business now. And the red areas are the areas where the farmers producing most of their income with animal productions. The yellow one, they're producing simple crops like cereals, potatoes, sugar beets or rapeseed, and the green areas are with intensive crops. Yeah? So wine and fruits. And here are the main areas now for fruits, vegetables, wine, and flowers. You see, it's changed to the south. Yeah. In north, we are strong in animal productions and in cereals. It's clear you can't feed the pigs with wine and olives. Yeah. And so we have a strong south in vegetable. This differentiation in the areas is accompanied by a differentiation in farms itself. This is our beloved traditional farms, our little farm. Then, with a lot of different animals, with a lot of different crops, this farm has gone. Now we have a separated production lines. We have specialists for everything. We have specialists for fruits, for vegetables, and in the vegetables, we have specialists for some vegetables. Yeah. We need machinery. Machinery is expensive, so you need a certain amount of fields, of areas. You can't do everything. The farmers specialized in that type of production, it's best in their region. Society has some profit of this differentiation? Yes, it has. In the year 1961, we were 3 billion people on Earth. Over 1 billion was hungry. Now we are 7 billion people, and not even 1 billion is definition of FAO hungry. The others have enough to eat. This is an achievement of the modern and global agriculture. It's not an achievement of any type of centrally planned economy. And main key to achieve this nutrition is trade. Here, also the year 1961, the German trade balance for food, and the blue columns are our actual trade balance for food. We had in 61 a big import surplus for vegetables, and we have an even bigger one today. But in the other main products, Germany changed from a big importer to a big exporter. Imagine the yields gone up much better. We can produce meat out of our cereal surplus. But in fruits and vegetables, we are importers, big importers. Why? We prefer fresh food at any time of the year, and we prefer economically priced food. So our self-sufficiency for fruits and vegetables declined with our wealth. Now it's stable on a low level. It's easier to produce salad at that time in Spain than here, of course. We export also some salad to Spain, believe it, in August. Maybe iceberg salad. It's too hot in Spain at this time for salads. And at the same time, our self-sufficiency in Germany for meat and potatoes, plants who are growing well here, explode. We are exporters of this. It's a differentiation in the fields. And also we get richer, more income, means more variety of food, less regional productions, better food. In former times, the Germans had not enough money, they had to eat potatoes. Forget the German nickname Kraut. The more actual nickname is potato eater. We are still eating a lot of potatoes. But it was the cheapest way to feed the population, with potatoes. So we had more money, we ate other things. First of all, meat. A poor population, is it here in Germany or is it in India somewhere else? At first, a working population, if they had more money, at first they will buy meat and fish. So, our consumption of meat get a top level in the 80s, now it's declining slightly. But our consumption of vegetables is still increasing. It's good vegetable, it's not the former crowd. All kinds of good vegetables. And this is a per capita consumption of fruits, it's a statistical fault here. We always counted the backyard, apple trees, and so on at this time, and now we have seen the apple trees are gone, there's lawn. And so this miscalculation at this time is in the statistics. The people don't even eat their fruits in the garden because that's not so fine, they're not so pretty. In East Germany, the situation of 1950 was conservated. They have a regional and seasonal food all the time. So what do you do with a regional or a seasonal surplus of cucumbers? You have to pickle it. A regional food and seasonal food is our past. I can't imagine it's our future. Imagine in East Germany that they have enough food at affordable prices, but they didn't have a lot of imports. This discussion about regional and seasonal food is like living in a scripted reality. Yeah. Polls and the published opinion are not, or the published opinion are not the public opinion. An example, the presidential elections in the United States, there were proposals, the people of California had to decide if they want labeling their food. The food industry should be forced to take a label on it. This contains genetically modified materials. A big campaign. There were spots on TV with little child. I'm not a lab rat. Very emotional. At the end of this campaign, there was a campaign against this labeling, financed also by BASF with 2 million greenbacks, and Monsanto is, I think, with 9 million. And this is the result. The proposal 37 failed. The people of California, we the people, decided they don't want labeling their food. Nobody would have believed it before, because we are living in a like scripted reality. Bad food, poisoned food, cruelty to animals. This is not the reality. And this reality is influencing our mind. It's also influencing the FAO. These are slides from the FAO. Yeah. Who is in charge of the hunger in the world? Yeah. The overweighted people. This is not a poster of FAO. It is an actual poster. It's a poster of the US Food Administration at wartime. But it's in fashion today. The scripted reality is influencing the reality. Here, 7% of the European cereal production is wasted because overweighted people are eating too much. It works. Do you feel it? It's an FAO slide. This can lead to misunderstandings. You know, biofuels some years ago were seen as a big surplus for the environment, and now people are eating too much. Biofuels is becoming increasingly more expensive. This makes a big confusion about the whole discussion about agriculture. Do we need a food coaching? I have seen this window in Hanover. Personal training, food coaching. So are you worried about your food? Take a personal trainer. It's a big confusion. Or such a political campaign poster. No, nutrition is a matter of attitude. Attitude. German specialty. Forget the tasty food. Take the one with a good attitude. Can we pickle that? This FAO-based oracle won the prize, non-statistic of the month, January, this January in Germany. This is another example of a scripted reality. Potatoes harvested in Europe, most of them will end at food losses. It's not real. It's a junk science. You can send it to Portlandia. Portlandia is a sitcom in the United States making jokes about politically correct behavior. And this is a complete statistical tableau. It's published in a Swiss newspaper, the Beobachter. No one of these features is correct, is real. It's a big problem, wasting foods. Yes, but it's also a problem to make the features bigger than they are. It's time for a conclusion. Does more organic food mean more regional food, more seasonal food, smaller shops, other vegetables, other fruits, other business for you? Smaller shops? Or does it mean more big organic farms, more imports, more organic supermarkets, or just some organic food in the supermarket next street? Here on Saturday, grapes from South Africa, organic grapes of South Africa. What will the mainstream do? Yeah, you are living from the mainstream. The mainstream is this what I notice in my statistics. The customer will decide. In the mainstream, I will make you an example. The customer will decide where he wants to buy. If it will be organic food, and what he is telling about us, about his decision. Nevertheless, yeah, he can tell you what he is doing, or he can tell you what the actual meaning or the actual correct behavior would be. Normally, you get the correct behavior as a reply, and not what he is choosing in the supermarket. An example, here's the top seller of apples in the United States. In 1 year, this company gets to the top seller of apples in the United States. Sliced apples in a plastic bag, some acid in it, some acid liquid, so the apple don't get brown. Finger food, because McDonald's customers are used to finger food. Yeah. So this invitations, this new achievements, these are new ideas. This is your business. And your business will live on these little steps forward. Yeah. Sometimes there are great ideas, but normally there will be no big change. There's no signs that we go back to a farm like Gutello of Johann Heinrich von Thüne. Thank you.
BASF, the chemical company.